Article, Wikipedia article audio. An article is a word that is used with a noun to specify grammatical definiteness of the noun, and in some languages extending to volume or numerical scope. The articles in English grammar are the na slash an, and in certain contexts some. An and a are modern forms of the Old English an, which in Anglian dialects was the number one and survived into modern Scots as the number oan. Both on and survived into modern English, with one used as the number and as an indefinite article. Definite article. Indefinite article. In many languages, articles are a special part of speech which cannot easily be combined with other parts of speech. In English grammar, articles are frequently considered part of a broader category called determiners, which contains articles, demonstratives, possessive determiners, and quantifiers. Articles and other determiners are also sometimes counted as a type of adjective, since they describe the words that they come before. In languages that employ articles, every common noun, with some exceptions, is expressed with a certain definiteness, definite or indefinite, as an attribute. Articles are among the most common words in many languages. In English, for example, the most frequent word is the. Articles are usually categorized as either definite or indefinite. A few languages with well-developed systems of articles may distinguish additional subtypes. Within each type, languages may have various forms of each article, due to conforming to grammatical attributes such as gender, number, or case. Articles may also be modified as influenced by adjacent sounds or words as in elision, epenthesis, or contraction. The definite article is used to refer to a particular member of a group or class. It may be something that the speaker has already mentioned, or it may be something uniquely specified. There is one definite article in English, for both singular and plural nouns, the. The sentence above refers to specific children in a specific way home. It contrasts with the much more general observation that. Proper article. The latter sentence refers to children in general and their specific ways home. Likewise, refers to a specific book whose identity is known or obvious to the listener, as such it has a markedly different meaning from. Partitive article, which uses an indefinite article, which does not specify what book is to be given. The definite article can also be used in English to indicate a specific class among other classes. However, recent developments show that definite articles are morphological elements linked to certain noun types due to lexicalization. Under this point of view, definiteness does not play a role in the selection of a definite article more than the lexical entry attached to the article. Negative article. An indefinite article indicates that its noun is not a particular one identifiable to the listener. It may be something that the speaker is mentioning for the first time, or the speaker may be making a general statement about any such thing. A slash an are the indefinite articles used in English. The form an is used before words that begin with a vowel sound, and a before words that begin with a consonant sound. Zero article. Before some words beginning with a pronounced H in an unstressed first syllable, such as historic, hallucination, hilarious, horrendous, and horrific, some British writers prefer to use an over A. An is also preferred before hotel by some writers of British English. The use of an before words beginning with an unstressed H is more common generally in British English than in American. American writers normally use a in all these cases, although there are occasional uses of an historic in American English. According to the New Oxford Dictionary of English, such use is increasingly rare in British English too. Unlike British English, American English typically uses an before verb, since the H in this word is silent for most Americans. The correct usage in respect of the term hereditary peer was the subject of an amendment debated in the UK Parliament. Variation among languages. The word some can be viewed as functionally a plural of a slash in that, for example, an apple never means more than one apple but give me some apples indicates more than one is desired but without specifying a quantity. In this view it is functionally homologous to the Spanish plural indefinite article unos slash unas. Un slash una is completely indistinguishable from the unit number, except where it has a plural form. Thus de muna manzana but de munas manzanas. The indefiniteness of some or unos can sometimes be semi-quantitatively narrowed, as in there are some apples there, but not many. Some also serves as a singular indefinite article, as in there is some person on the porch. Toklauan. A proper article indicates that its noun is proper, and refers to a unique entity. It may be the name of a person, the name of a place, the name of a planet, etc. The Maori language has the proper article a, which is used for personal nouns, so, a pita means Peter. In Maori, when the personal nouns have the definite or indefinite article as an important part of it, both articles are present, for example, the phrase a te raparaha, which contains both the proper article a and the definite article te refers to the person named te raparaha. The definite article is sometimes also used with proper names, which are already specified by definition. For example, the Amazon, the Hebrides. In these cases, the definite article may be considered superfluous. Its presence can be accounted for by the assumption that they are shorthand for a longer phrase in which the name is a specifier, i.e. the Amazon River, the Hebridean Islands. Where the nouns in such longer phrases cannot be omitted, the definite article is universally kept, the United States, the People's Republic of China. This distinction can sometimes become a political matter. The former usage the Ukraine stressed the word's Russian meaning of borderlands, as Ukraine became a fully independent state following the collapse of the Soviet Union, it requested that formal mentions of its name omit the article. Similar shifts in usage have occurred in the names of Sudan and both Congo and Congo, a move in the other direction occurred with the Gambia. In certain languages, such as French and Italian, definite articles are used with all or most names of countries, La France slash Le Canada slash El Alamagni, L'Italia slash La Spagna slash Il Brasil. If a name a definite article, e.g. the Kremlin, it cannot idiomatically be used without it. We cannot say Boris Yeltsin is in Kremlin. Some languages also use definite articles with personal names. For example, such use is standard in Portuguese, in Greek, and in Catalan. It also occurs colloquially in Spanish, German, French, Italian, and other languages. In Hungary it is considered to be a Germanism. Rarely, this usage can appear in English. A prominent example is how President of the United States and businessman Donald Trump is known as the Donald, this wording being used by many publications such as Newsweek and New York Post. Another is U.S. President Ronald Reagan's nickname of the Jipper. Publisher Townhall.com issued an article after Reagan's death titled simply Goodbye to the Jipper. Evolution. A partitive article is a type of article, sometimes viewed as a type of indefinite article, used with a mass noun such as water, to indicate a nonspecific quantity of it. Partitive articles are thus a class of determiner. They are used in French and Italian in addition to definite and indefinite articles. The nearest equivalent in English is some, although the latter is classified as a determiner but not in all authorities' classifications as an indefinite article, and English uses it less than French uses de. Definite articles. Haida has a partitive article referring to part of something or to one or more objects of a given group or category, e.g., Tluagia uu halpa long, he is making a boat. Albanian, zog, a bird, zog u, the bird. Aramaic, peace, the peace. Note, Aramaic is written from right to left, so an aleph is added to the end of the word. Becomes when it is not the final letter. A negative article specifies none of its noun, and can thus be regarded as neither definite nor indefinite. On the other hand, some consider such a word to be a simple determiner rather than an article. In English, this function is fulfilled by no, which can appear before a singular or plural noun. The zero article is the absence of an article. In languages having a definite article, the lack of an article specifically indicates that the noun is indefinite. Linguists interested in X-bar theory causally link zero articles to nouns lacking a determiner. In English, the zero article rather than the indefinite is used with plurals and mass nouns, although the word some can be used as an indefinite plural article. Hebrew, transcribed as yeld, a boy. Transcribed as ha yeld, the boy. Articles are found in many Indo-European languages, Semitic languages, and Polynesian languages, but are formally absent from many of the world's major languages, such as Chinese, Indonesian, Japanese, Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu, Russian, the majority of Slavic and Baltic languages, Yoruba, and the Bantu languages. In some languages that do have articles, like for example some North Caucasian languages, the use of articles is optional, but in others like English and German it is mandatory in all cases. Indefinite articles. Linguists believe the common ancestor of the Indo-European languages, Proto-Indo-European, did not have articles. Most of the languages in this family do not have definite or indefinite articles. There is no article in Latin or Sanskrit, nor in some modern Indo-European languages, such as the families of Slavic languages and Baltic languages. Although classical Greek had a definite article, the earlier Homeric Greek used this article largely as a pronoun or demonstrative, whereas the earliest known form of Greek known as Mycenaean Greek did not have any articles. Articles developed independently in several language families. Not all languages have both definite and indefinite articles, and some languages have different types of definite and indefinite articles to distinguish finer shades of meaning. For example, French and Italian have a partitive article used for indefinite mass nouns, whereas Colonian has two distinct sets of definite articles indicating focus and uniqueness, and Macedonian uses definite articles in a demonstrative sense, with the tripartite distinction based on distance from the speaker or interlocutor. The words this and that can be understood in English as ultimately, forms of the definite article they. In many languages, the form of the article may vary according to the gender, number, or case of its noun. In some languages, the article may be the only indication of the case. Many languages do not use articles at all, and may use other ways of indicating old versus new information, such as topic comment constructions. Plural, e, ene. Plural, ene, a. Plural, ane, ene, a. Plural, na, a, n. Asterisk. Grammatically speaking, Finnish has no articles, but the words se and yks are used in the same fashion as the na slash n in English and are, for all intents and purposes, treated like articles when used in this manner in colloquial Finnish. The following examples show articles which are always suffixed to the noun. Example of prefixed definite article. A different way, limited to the definite article, is used by Latvian and Lithuanian. The noun does not change, but the adjective can be defined or undefined. In Latvian, galds, a table slash the table, baltas galds, a white table, baltas galds, the white table. In Lithuanian, stalas, a table slash the table, baltas stalas, a white table, baltas is stalas, the white table. Languages in the above table written in italics are constructed languages and are not natural, that is to say that they have been purposefully invented by an individual with some purpose in mind. They do, however, all belong to language families themselves. Esperanto is derived from European languages and therefore all of its roots are found in Proto-Indo-European, and cognates can be found in real-world languages like French, German, Italian and English. Interlingua is also based on European languages, but with its main source being that of Italic descendant languages, English, French, Spanish, Italian and Portuguese, with German and Russian being secondary sources, with words from further afield contributing to the language's vocabulary. The result is a supposedly easy-to-learn language for the world. As well as these auxiliary languages, the list contains two more, Kanya and Sindarin. These two languages were created by Professor Tolkien and used in his fictional works. They are not based on any real-world language family, but do share a common history with roots in common Eldarin. When using a definite article in Toklauan language, unlike in some languages like English, if the speaker is speaking of an item, they need not to have referred to it previously as long as the item is specific. This is also true when it comes to the reference of a specific person. So, although the definite article used to describe a noun in the Toklauan language is te, it can also translate to the indefinite article in languages that requires the item being spoken of to have been referenced prior. When translating to English, te could translate to the English definite article they, or it could also translate to the English indefinite article a. An example of how the definite article te can be used as an interchangeable definite or indefinite article in the Toklauan language would be the sentence qua hau te tino. In the English language, this could be translated as a man has arrived or the man has arrived, where using te as the article in this sentence can represent any man or a particular man. The word he, which is the indefinite article in Toklauan, is used to describe any such item. The word he is used in negative statements because that is where it is most often found, alongside its great use in interrogative statements. Though this is something to make note of, he is not used in just in negative statements and questions alone. Although these two types of statements are where he occurs the most, it is also used in other statements as well. An example of the use of he as an indefinite article is vili ake oikeame I hitoki, where hitoki mean an axe. The use of he and te in Toklauan are reserved for when describing a singular noun. However, when describing a plural noun, different articles are used. For plural definite nouns, rather than te, the article na with makron is used. Vili ak oi ka ma ina with makron nofo in tok laoan would translate to do run and bring me the chairs in English. There are some special cases in which instead of using na with makron, plural definite nouns have no article before them. The absence of an article is represented by zero. One way that it is usually used is if a large amount or a specific class of things are being described. Occasionally, such as if one was describing an entire class of things in a non-specific fashion, the singular definite noun te would is used. In English, kote povee kaimusha means cows eat grass. Because this is a general statement about cows, te is used instead of na with makron. The ko serves as a preposition to the te. The article ni is used for describing a plural indefinite noun. Eieini to I translates to are there any books? Articles have developed independently in many different language families across the globe. Generally, articles develop over time, usually by specialization of certain adjectives or determiners, and their development is often a sign of languages becoming more analytic instead of synthetic, perhaps combined with the loss of inflection as in English, Romance languages, Bulgarian, Macedonian and Torlakian. Joseph Greenberg in Universals of Human Language describes the cycle of the definite article. Definite articles evolve from demonstratives, and in turn can become generic articles that may be used in both definite and indefinite contexts, and later merely noun markers that are part of nouns other than proper names and more recent borrowings. Eventually, articles may evolve anew from demonstratives. Definite articles typically arise from demonstratives, meaning that, for example, the definite articles in the Romance languages, e.g., l, il, le, la, lo, derive from the Latin demonstratives il, illa, and illud. The English definite article they, written e in Middle English, derives from an Old English demonstrative, which, according to gender, was written se, co, or t. The neuter form t also gave rise to the modern demonstrative that. The ye occasionally seen in pseudo-archaic usage such as ye Old English tea shop is actually a form of e, where the letter thorn came to be written as ay. Multiple demonstratives can give rise to multiple definite articles. Macedonian, for example, in which the articles are suffixed, has, the chair, this chair, and, that chair. These derive from the common Slavic demonstratives asterisk t this, that, asterisk ov this here and asterisk on that over there, yonder respectively. Colonian prepositions articles such as in dat auto, or et auto, the car, the first being specifically selected, focused, newly introduced, while the latter is not selected, unfocused, already known, general, or generic. Standard Basque distinguishes between proximal and distal definite articles in the plural. The Basque distal form functions as the default definite article, whereas the proximal form is marked and indicates some kind of close relationship between the speaker and the referent, itsik versus itsiok, euskaljunak versus euskaljunok. Indefinite articles typically arise from adjectives meaning one. For example, the indefinite articles in the Romance languages e.g., un, una, un derive from the Latin adjective unus. Partitive articles, however, derive from Vulgar Latin de illo, meaning of the. The English indefinite article an is derived from the same root as one. The n came to be dropped before consonants, giving rise to the shortened form a. The existence of both forms has led to many cases of juncture loss, for example transforming the original anapron into the modern an apron. The Persian indefinite article is yak, meaning one.